The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
You are now tuning in to Laron Pierce's Hip Hop Show. Roscoe's Media Center presents the Hip Hop Show, hosted by Laron Pierce, the JJE in the building.
The way some been down from day one, never been known for mistakes, but was bound to make one. Her name was Nina. See, he was all about the cash flow till she came and had this man pussy whipped to the max, yo. A true dime piece, describing the brown eyes, caramel skin, thick thighs, goes beyond speech. But besides looks, her mind's lost. Known for kicking cats in the curb, leaving their hearts on the sidewalk. Sean was one of them. She said she was loving him, but only fucking him, cause he had some funds coming in. He couldn't see it though. She was cheating and he didn't even know. He even bought a crib with the scheming hoe. In a ride, mad jewels, mad clothes, mad shoes. And to show his commitment, he got a name tattoo. I gotta hand it to her. She had her stuff planned out, but watch what happened when the luck ran out. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. You up now, but you'll get yours somehow, someday, in some way, shape, or form. Revenge is coming, no way to escape the storm. What goes around comes around. What goes up must come down. You up now, but you'll get yours somehow, someday, in some way, shape, or form. Revenge is coming, no way to escape the storm. Time passes. Sean is thinking about wedding rings, but he knows his sons are cheating and doesn't want to believe them. He disregards them, goes out for diamond ring shopping. Now the big question is, when is he gonna pop it? Waiting for the right time. Meanwhile, Nina's the same hoe, like a snare drum, but bang way more. For Sean, up to this point, shit's going well. So one day, his homeboy hit him on his cell.
Yo,
like,
son, you won't believe this. I just seen your chick in the mall with this cat. He was palming the ass. I swear to God, son, need me to run up on him and drop him?
Nah, chill, I got this. I hit you back if it's popping. He hung up but called Nina.
Where you at? What you doing?
At the mall with some friends, buying new Tim's.
Something sounded funny, she was lying for sure, but Sean had a little plot of his own. Check it. What goes around comes around, what goes up must come down. You up now, but you'll get yours somehow, someday, in some way, shape, or form. Revenge is coming, no way to escape the storm. What goes around comes around, what goes up must come down. You up now, but you'll get yours somehow, someday, in some way, shape, or form. Revenge is coming, peep how he plays this whore. I miss you.
Yep. So okay, what's the deal, everybody? Welcome to the Prince of LA Show. Today, I'm here with my co-host, A-Game. Say what's up.
What's up?
So we right here. We got the question of the day today. We got, you know, I'm going to be DJing maybe today, you know what I mean? Playing some bangers. I might be DJing, you feel me? Today, we have no guest artists, but we still going to be turning up on the show. This is the Prince of LA Show, everybody. I need y'all to stay tuned in all show.
Tuesday. We didn't switch from Thursdays to Tuesdays.
Yep, it's the Prince of LA Show. Y'all done tuned in.
Taking over Tuesdays.
This was already our show. We don't need to take over.
What we're doing is we just going through the studio, taking over what we can, basically.
Exactly. This is the Prince of LA Show, but I mean, you know, it's the Prince of LA Show. I'm the Prince of LA. That's it, game. We taking over every single day of the week. This is our show.
We're going to do something.
So, if y'all expecting to see another show, don't expect to see it.
No,
this is
it's
our
the
show.
Prince of LA Show.
Yep.
There it is.
So, the question of the day today. Whoa.
First of all,
wow.
This is the hip hop show. This is not the Prince of LA, although they are the guests of the show. I am your host, Laron Pierce, the JJE, yep, in the building, you know what I'm saying? And we are here with the guests with RJizzle, Westbred, and A-Game from Prince of LA Show. So, how you guys are doing today?
We are peachy. I am cold. I'm always cold. The weather. No, we good though.
She always like Mr. Herbert, always cold. But
cold, sure.
But I'm here and I'm not cold because I got a jacket on, so I'm not even cold at all.
I got a jacket on too.
Well, I'm not cold because my jacket keeps me warm.
I don't know if you guys saw my Instagram, but I said it while I was at Roscoe's last week, and I said, "You know who I am? I'm Zub Zero."
I seen that video.
I don't get cold.
Yeah, I do.
Sub-Zero is cold. How can you not get cold and Sub-Zero is cold?
Well, Erica, you...
Well, if anybody doesn't know what Sub-Zero is, Sub-Zero is a character of Mortal Kombat. He's one of my favorites of all time.
Yeah, we know.
Also Scorpion and Jax, so... Yeah.
Jack sucks, first off.
Yo, Grandma was playing it earlier today.
I was playing.
His grandma was playing Mortal Kombat today.
First off, Jack sucks. Liu Kang
we're talking about more.
Liu Kang is the best one. Yes. Liu Kang. Liu Kang has the bicycle kick. But anyway, off this Sub-Zero subject. Anyway, I don't know how we got caught into it. But yes, I seen that video, LP. Continue.
Yes.
Yeah, I appreciate it, man. We're about to go into a break, so stay tuned.
Turned 20 when in prison, locked up at night. Now I walk around free, it seems like another life. Another roll with some other dice. Another hoe or a loving wife. People come and go, some really you never know. Intellectual midgets that really never grow. Fake love that hangs on like, can I hold you though? And no friends that look at you like, yo, yeah, I told you so. A toast to the brokenhearted who never finished what they fucking started. People who go out and try to be a rebel at night. They try to make up for the fact that they settled in life. It's like a fight between the devil and Christ over the limelight. Spiritual celebrity poker, but the whole deck is full of jokers. And every year that you get older, the stakes get higher. Gambling with a bunch of fakes and liars. Real talk, cause the real New York is the pain and the suffering, a lost love. Staring off into the distance in the midst of the club. Depression and emptiness to lead to suicide. And the struggle inside of yourself that keeps you alive. Surviving medicated, stalked by sobriety. The life you live now, tortured by memories violently. I pray inside of me that one day you could be forgiven for murdering the beautiful world we used to live in. Need a complicated metaphor, and sometimes nothing needs to be said at all. Sometimes the person you with is not your one and only, and you just fuck with them because you're afraid to be lonely. And when you come back, it's too late, so you overcompensate like victims of rape with a self-hate. Lost in the affection of strangers around you, instead of the only person that ever gave a fuck about you. Thought you were happy, so you didn't come check me. But then when he cheated or treated you incorrectly, you conveniently realized you could never forget me, and tried to crawl back in my life unexpectedly. These are my indictments for those who claim to be righteous and leave a trail of broken hearts on their way to enlightenment. But I can't give into hatred or past judgment, even towards every illusion I've been in love with. Cause the heart that betrays itself willingly is like a nation that trades freedom for stability. It's so seductive to be cold and corrupted and isolated. Trying to be an independent republic, but liberty to be loved on the surface is worthless. The sacrifice of revolution with no purpose, taken from a criminal searching for his redemption. Cursing God, desperately trying to get his attention.
Since a youngin', I was dreamin' of getting rich. Look at me, my nigga, fantasize about a white picket fence. That's the trees, my nigga, used to want a pathfinder with some tents. That's all I need, my nigga, throw some 20s on that bitch and get it rinsed. But now I see, my nigga, that the world's a lot bigger ever since. Picked up the paper and they say my nigga had it caught a body, I'm convinced. Anybody is a killer, all you gotta do is push them to the lips. Fuck
being timid in the civic, politicking with the pushers and the pimps. I'm trying to write a story, can I get a glimpse? And can I get a glimpse? Last night I had a bad dream. That I was trapped in the city, then I asked, is that really such a bad thing? They robbing niggas on the daily, can you blame a nigga that ain't ever had things?
What's the value of thing?
Guess not. Last night, they put up on my nigga at the light like, nice watch, run it.
Hands in the air now, hands in the air,
run it.
Hands in the air now, hands in the air,
run it.
Hands in the air now, hands in the air, hands in the air now, hands in the air.
Small town nigga, Hollywood dreams, I know that everything that glitters ain't gold. I know this shit ain't always good as it seems, but tell me till you get it, how could you know?
How could you know?
How could you know? Listen up, I'm about to go and get rich. Fuck with me, my nigga, we gon' suck around the villain, hit a lick. Got some tree, my nigga, and some powder, bag it up and make a flip. You gon' see, my nigga, one day we gon' graduate and cop a brick. And that's the key, my nigga, listen up, I'm about to go and get rich. Stand back and watch if you want to, nigga. Me, I want my pockets fatter, better, bitch. Tired of seeing niggas flaunt, I wanna flaunt too, nigga. Watch some rollers in the fucking Crown Vic. Trying like a nigga up, that's what they won't do, nigga. Wanna know a funny thing about this shit? Even if you let them kill your dream, it'll haunt you, nigga, haunt you. Last night I had a bad dream. That I was trapped in the city, then I asked, is that really such a bad thing? I look around like, do you wanna be another nigga that ain't ever had things?
What's the value of the thing?
Guess not. Last night, we put up on a nigga at the light like, nice watch, run it.
Hands in the air now, hands in the air,
run it.
Hands in the air now.
Okay, that was Turned Up J. Cole. You back to the Prince of L.A. show. Let's do it. Let's do it, J. Cole.
Insist on taking over. Insist on taking over.
It's the Prince of L.A. show. You feel me? That was J. Cole. We playing all the hottest stuff on the Prince of L.A. show. You can only find that on the Prince of L.A. show.
Prince of L.A. show.
Yeah, you know, that's our show, but I mean.
That's our show, the Prince of L.A. show.
That's, you can only find hottest bangers on our show. I mean,
on the Prince of L.A. show.
Yes.
Yeah. Seriously? Yeah.
What?
You
what?
Guys are killing
Whoa.
Me right now, right?
Whoa.
This is ain't even close to the Prince of L.A. show. This is the hip-hop show, and we're back on live, you know what I'm saying? So, RJizzle.
Yes.
So what we doing today, man?
Well, you know, we talking about the hottest stuff going on in hip-hop right now.
What's
the,
that?
The latest beef, the hottest
that?
New music.
What's
the,
that?
The Hollywood drama. We talking about everything
What's
on
that?
The hip-hop show. Everything. We'll get right into that.
Right.
Okay, we can go right into the hip hop beef.
Let's go.
I don't know if anybody heard this, but yesterday YG and DJ Mustard, they're really close friends, and I know them, well, I don't really know them personally, but I know both of them at the same time because I met them at Roscoe. I met YG at Roscoe's 2 years ago. Mm. And there was this chick saying that I look like YG without tattoos. I was like kind of a little offended a little bit, but I was like,
offended.
I didn't really trick. But I'm cool with YG, you know what I mean? He's cool, but
well, I don't know too much about it.
I just found out when
came across someone else's blog that had reposted a tweet he sent out. Basically, it said something about, like, stop asking about YG stuff. He don't even know. He still ain't even got paid from the album. That's all I know. I ain't heard nothing else. I ain't seen nothing else. I haven't seen or read or anything on YG side or whatever. So I really don't know the depth. Still really won't know the depth because we in the inside. You know what I'm saying? It's always going to be a through whatever. It's just who's the most accurate, you know? But so.
Well. My opinion, I just found out about this when I came into the studio just about 30, 40 minutes ago. So, and I seen screenshots, and I guess a lot of people didn't get paid from YG's album. A lot of people didn't get their money. People were mad. It was fighting involved. That's
he
all
got
I,
his money?
No.
YG got his money?
I mean, I assume it's his album, but I mean, other people who worked on it with him didn't get the money, such as producers, executive producers, engineers who recorded
well,
and helped him
be,
mix.
Wouldn't them be some of the people that would get paid before the artist anyway?
Exactly.
Right?
But.
Okay.
But.
I just thought it's the question. I didn't know. I wasn't sure. I was just throwing
But that's all I have to say.
Right? Don't that make sense? Okay, so that's why I was throwing out there. That's why you got paid for it. Oh no. Don't they say the artists get paid last? Oh no. So I mean, so if he ain't got paid, maybe he ain't got either. So maybe ain't got nothing to do with his piece. Like maybe it's the people. You know how they always talk, oh, I have my people talking with your people. Maybe it's the people.
Probably. Right. What do you think, LP?
Well, I'm gonna read the story real quick on hiphopdx.com as I go along into it. What's really stupid about this beef, because they are making money. They're both making money out of nowhere. Maybe not this album, maybe not DJ Mustard's album. You know, I mean, they're both making money somehow. And I think this beef is fake, but at the same time, it's like, it's relevant. It's really stupid. And
I think on our side, some might say, I don't wouldn't say if it's real, if it what it is, then of course the situation at hand isn't stupid because everybody want their dough. So you know what I'm saying. But outside wise, I mean, shoot, be 100 with you, it ain't gonna make or break me because I ain't got nothing to do with it. Hey, like the music, whatever it is, but you know what I'm saying, it ain't finna stop nothing on my end. So of course, you know, some people will consider it as being stupid. Probably something that didn't even need to be out. That may be a reason why, like Laron said, it might be something fake, publicity stunt or something like that. But then why would you need to do that right now?
I mean, I don't think...
It's not like he's not relevant or, you know what I'm saying, so...
I don't think it's fake. I mean, I think it's 100% real. People just right mad because they didn't get their money, but, I mean, I think it's 100% it real, though.
Okay, I mean, okay, yeah, I said, who cares?
And first of all, they beef over Instagram. Like, why would you guys beef over Instagram? That's pathetic. Like,
I mean, look, but they're I don't feel they're beefing over Instagram. I feel like they put the beef out on Instagram. And I'm not saying they're... I believe they've seen each other in person already. I'm not saying, because that is different.
It ain't even that. They ain't got to see each other in person. I mean, come on. You really think they ain't got each other's current cell phone numbers?
Oh, yeah. YG posted a screenshot of him calling DJ Mustard like a gang of times. Answer the phone, fat boy. That's what the caption said. Quote me.
See? So then there you go right there. I don't know. It's a lot of things you could play into it. I personally.
Well, let's go in deep to this this news that was yesterday. YG threatens DJ Mustard. Producer said he wasn't paid for YG's album, which I don't know if that's the case, but we'll go get into it right now. So YG and DJ Mustard working relationship dates back 4 years due to YG's 2010 mixtape. Mm-hmm. The Real Four Fingers. This year, Mustard produced more than half of the tracks on YG's album, My Crazy Life. Together, they topped the charts with singles like Mine and Word, Left Right, and the Drake-assisted Who Do You Love? But today, well, yesterday, December 29th, their banner year took a turn for the worse when Mustard decided to air out his grievances for his West Coast comrade on Instagram. In an Instagram post that has since been deleted, the award-winning producer wrote, "Stop asking me about the YG-ish. I don't know why. I don't know none of them. On top of that, I ain't still getting paid. I still ain't got paid for this album, so I don't give a f." Shortly after, YG responded by reposting the image with a harsh caption.
Oh, don't read it.
Just read it.
I'm gonna read it, but. He said, bleep.
Just read it.
I will bleep out the words, but it's like, really?
Just say, like, the first letter of the word, then just read it.
Man. Oh, look, I was about to just.
We like to keep everything real on a hip-hop show / Prince of LA show.
Look.
Just read it, Laron. Just read it.
Nah. I'm just going to say one word, and
wow.
That's it.
Wow.
He said, fuck everybody. They
oh, my God.
DJ Mustard.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Let me
you
say
supposed
it.
To say
it.
Okay, okay,
it
okay.
Let
messing.
Me see. This
okay,
what
let me rephrase that.
I'm putting it in A-game word. Let me say
Let me rephrase that. Let me rephrase that.
Oh, my.
Screw everybody that ain't got paid for my album, he wrote. DJ Mustard, I know where your studio at, homeboy. That's me saying. Mustard on the beat, you know. You ain't never paid me for that or your album, brother.
There you go. That was a good improvision.
He said, oh, I don't know. Hey, bro, I need to watch this replay on YouTube, and I'm going to post it.
Yeah.
And I'm going to post it.
Well, that was YG's you're response, funny, man. Right? That was YG's response to Mustard, right? So, well.
Whoa. Now, Laron, you funny, man.
This is another reason why I don't want to entertain it. And look, here I go on the show. But I don't want to entertain it because at the end of the day, we got two black males from the hood doing something to come up, got the limelight to a degree right about now, and then now this stupid stuff is happening. So now here y'all are, that then friends and buddies or whatever, grinded it out, coming up, got a little name, whatever it is, little status, and then now y'all finna do this, and then do it publicly? That don't make no sense. That now y'all going against each other. That's that black on black. You know what I mean? Y'all stand together, and now what's the division? Oh, is it the business? Is it the money? What is it? The money is the devil.
I mean,
everybody want it, but
exactly,
you know what I mean?
That's what I'm saying.
But it's like, is it that serious? I don't think it's that serious. You know you're going to get paid either way it go. Whether it be you think you're going to be gangster or you going the legal way, you're going to get your dough. You know what I'm saying?
You can't guarantee that, though.
No, I can't guarantee it, but if you're going about the means the right way, and it is what it is. I mean, evidence and facts and everything speaks for itself. So if you ain't got no issues, but I'm just, that's even deeper than my point is. Yeah. The point is, y'all started out together. Y'all doing what y'all doing and coming up. And now whatever the discrepancy is in between, whether it be paperwork or whatever it is, but now y'all blasting and now you're making yourselves look retarded.
Yeah, I mean, that's
because there's division
true.
Between the two
like,
of y'all.
That's
and
just
then
like
throw the whole blacks.
It's just like my boy M Free and DJ Mustard is kind of, you know. But
within the same circle.
They're all the same. YG Mustard, M Free, and Mustard. You know.
Shout out to.
Matter of fact, shout out Mike Free for making me that beat. It's a banger.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, matter of fact, Adrian, you owe me 50 cents from the ice cream truck. I'm just playing.
What?
I'm just playing. And LP owes me like 30 cents from the liquor store.
Was that a subject changer?
He took my change.
Was that a subject changer?
I don't remember nobody in this piece. So I don't know what y'all talking about. But
moving on.
So yeah, back to the story. The exchange escalated even further when Mustard reposted YG response with his own threatening caption.
Yeah.
I ain't no sucker ish. And the internet stuff weak and this internet stuff weak. We can get down for it. This won't be the first time. He wrote, "I'm gonna pull up and we can squabble up." I don't think that's how he said it, but he was like,
"I know
see
he
you
did
and-
say it like that. I seen the screenshot.
Man,
DJ Mustard did say
hey,
that.
Now they bad. Now y'all both sound retarded.
Now to me,
all this is oh, I know, beep. So let me go ahead and put it out. I mean, come on, for real." All of this right here didn't even need to be there. That could have been in your personal text back. Not even a text. Call me, brother. Or like you said, pull up. I'm pretty sure y'all know each other's schedules to a degree or know when, what, where, and when. You know what I'm saying?
That's
so,
how YG said he know where DJ Mustard Studio
is. It's retarded and it's a waste of time. Can we move on to the next subject?
I mean, I like both of y'all music still, so it don't matter.
I know, right? Your beats is banging. I mean, some of YG said, you know, it is what it is, but... For real, this is like a waste of time. Because what's going
to
happen?
And you guys are supposed to be the new Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg, and y'all doing this type of stuff?
I get it. Everybody's human, but here goes this piece. Now, after you've already blasted something, now you want to say, oh, forget the internet. Why? What? You should have said, thought that before even posting anything, period, then.
Exactly.
Unless you tried and it was no success, and then now this is your way of trying to, okay, well, since you don't want to... holler at me like that, I got another way to make you respond. But then if that's the case, then stomp on your rat. No, I'm just
playing. Wow. YG, wow. Mustard,
I'm just kidding,
please.
But y'all know, come
end
on.
The beef. It's not worth it. Sense. You guys both are making money, you guys are successful, and you guys are from the same state that we are in. Come on now. This is West Coast we talking about here. So end the beef.
Handle
no
it the right way. I mean, come
no
on.
No question, no
handle
discussion.
Right
just way. End it. It's not worth it. All right? So moving on to the next topic. Nick Cannon addresses... Really? This is why I don't like Nick Cannon, because he's a piece...
He did that?
He's a full of crap. He's crap. So, like...
Can we find something positive to talk about?
Come on, Laron. If you're going to be a star, you cannot trash talk other stars. Come on, LP.
Well, no,
that's why I'm not
going to
say nothing, but it's like...
It's just discussing what's already there, but then you end up giving your opinions, and then...
Right.
Can we find something positive? Let's get some good stuff. What's going on good right now? Hey, and yeah. Going
nah, but
into
we like to keep everything real on the Prince of LA.
That's fine.
Slash the hip-hop show.
So let's do this.
Okay.
We got good things coming for the Prince of LA show 2015.
Come on. This is the hip-hop show. Show some respect for my man.
Matter of fact, let's go to the end.
What?
Screw the news. We're going to go into this Prince of LA show. So this, the topic is today is the Prince of LA part two. So.
See?
So, RJizzle, so tell me what's going on with the Prince of LA show.
Well, we have soon we're gonna be. We already booked her today. I forgot her name.
Don't drop her. We got people coming for 2015.
No, I'm gonna tell them.
Don't drop
she
it.
Does with,
don't.
If she does with the thighs, like she like nothing
she
like
though.
That. I don't know her name, but when you tell
watch,
the girl,
y'all gonna know.
When you say
she's hilarious, because
I told the
she
dude who
issues.
Was in the studio, he's not in studio now. But before he went on air, I told him the girl who be dancing on Instagram. He said, "Yeah, the one who claps her thighs, yeah,
her knees."
Everybody
her
knows
knees.
That. Everybody.
She's
knows.
Funny. Hey.
Wow.
I don't think I never saw that, but that's kind of weird. But
you probably have.
Nah,
she's funny. You can tell she just don't care, and not that. Hey, I'm cool with that.
Might be a new girlfriend for LP. Maybe you know we might bring.
Might bring a new girl for LP.
Well, and again, I ain't matchmaking. I'm just talking about the guests. So back to. New updates for 2015 for the Prince of LA show.
Thank you.
You know, just, you know, we got some stuff coming. Trust me. We've been off for 2 weeks because of the holidays. You know what I'm saying? That's all right.
But, hey, you're on my show.
But we're on the show, so. Still flowing it through. So, technically, we've still been on, just on a different day. Boom, right?
Basically.
But, yeah, no, we got good stuff coming. New stuff, people, things, funny stuff. It's going to be dope.
Right.
Be real dope, yeah.
Yes.
If you guys want to tune in to even talk to me or A-Game or RJizzle Westbred, tune in rmconair.com, and then you can call in on 323-965-1600.
Yes.
Just let us know what you want to talk about and what songs you want to play, want us to play and stuff like that. So just hit us up.
We freestyle,
tune
right?
Tune in with me, RJizzle Westbred, A-Game, LP, Laron Pierce, Drace, you know.
Sub-Zero.
Who?
Sub-Zero.
Did you just say Laron Pierce Drace?
Sub-Zero. Yo.
Where did you get Drace from? How did you even know about Drace?
Yo. I don't know.
Yo, it's a lot of stuff you don't know about the host. So if you want to know, just hit him up on Instagram and learn about his history.
Just don't know. Like that, huh? That was dope. Yeah. We did.
Learn about his history, about his past nicknames, his past... You know, everything
you've
been doing.
Stay tuned to know about his future, right?
We're going to talk about that during the break.
Yeah. So, are we going into break LP right now, or you want to get on another subject?
I'm going to take a break.
We can get on a subject in a minute, so if we want, if you guys want to, before we go on a break.
Tinder. We can do it before. Let's do it after to keep the fans waiting.
Say yay, yay.
All right.
Go.
Let's go into it.
All right, let's go.
Bye. between the lines, you can feel my hunger. Only brother you know who can flow with Technicolor. Towel under the door to keep the cold from coming in. Trying to find a way to keep the income coming in. Purpose of the verses is my trouble and pain. Want freedom, fuck fame, struggle my middle name. So if you one in the same, memorize the slogan. Any law laid by the devil was made to be broken.
The rebel army, we fire at the federalies. In a concrete jungle on American safari. We call them out like Ali Ali Oxenfree. But you don't want to end up in the same box with me. My terrorist tape claim responsibility. Jason Bourne type niggas try killing me. Immortal guerrilla technique abilities keep me alive like the rebel inside spiritually.
In a city where the skinny niggas die. Well, I got the eye of the tiger, got my eyes on the prize. Cause I'm a plot, plan, and strategize. A rebel, I'm a vibe like fighters do. Do what I gotta do. Sometimes I talk to myself, what will Malcolm do? You can't stop my dude. The movement keeps on growing. And the going gets tough and tough. Get going, yo, Maya.
Let him know. So broken.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
911, where's your emergency?
Neighbor who watch me calling, cause I be beating off the Richter. We playing chess, not checkers like Lil Bobby Fischer. Beat banging, beat knocking, beat banging. King Kong, Godzilla, gorillas in the trunk. Yeah, I do it for my city, city, low rider city. From LA to Diego, flaming hot like Fuego. My beat bang, my beat bang. Time to turn up, my beat bang, my beat bang. I'm UPS with my delivery, cause when I go, we go. Let's go, pronto, CEO, head honcho. I break it down and demolish. My skills is too polished.
Real loud music real music real loud.
You know we had to do the remix.
Music real loud music real loud.
This is the remix.
You know we had to do the remix.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
This is the remix.
You know we had to do the remix.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
I don't need no window. I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
Music real loud.
This is the remix.
Music real.
This is the remix.
Music real.
This is the remix.
Beat make the glass break. I don't need no window. School you about the game. Take notes, get a pencil. You make it so difficult, I make it so simple. Simple. Time to lock the dogs in the kennel. Music real loud, blow your eardrums out. Homie, what you mad about? Cause I style out. If you need me, girl, call. All you do is dial out. She be mad if I don't pick up. These girls wallin' out. Like I look brand new from my head to my shoes. I know I took your girl, wasn't trying to be rude. But prepare for destruction, prepare for the worst. You know I'm killing this, be prepared to get it hurt. Look, it's time to go to work like I'm on a job. Look, it's time to get turned like a doorknob. Fly kid, look at this white fly in the D6. Fresh like my
beard.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
This is the remix.
You know we had to do the remix.
Beat knocking, beat knocking.
This is the remix.
You know we had to do the remix.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
You know we had to do the remix.
I don't need no window. I don't need no window.
This is the remix.
I don't need no window. Yeah, yo. What's the deal? We back to the Prince of LA show, and now I'm gonna talk different, you feel me?
You feel me? What? Can I talk different too?
I'm gonna have a British accent.
Uh-uh, don't do it.
I'm not very good
like
at
Milford.
It. I'm not very...
What did Milford say?
Look, my engineer Milford, we're in the car, right? He's like, I'm gonna have a British accent, and I'm gonna sound from Britannia. I say ain't no such thing as Britannia.
No.
What is a Britannia,
no,
Milford?
No, that, no.
My dad told me this morning, he said, He said, shout out to Milford. He and my dad said, what's bought and doesn't complete its task? Milford. Hey, no, I was just on the phone with Milford
Did y'all just
day.
Hear the crickets?
I was trying to, what?
Did you hear the crickets?
Wow. Oh, she's trying to say my joke wasn't funny. Hey, no, but that is a funny. If you know Milford, then it's funny. If you don't know him,
they don't know Milford. So it, anyway, I'm funny, though.
Well, hold up. So this is still the Prince of LA show.
No, man. It's not. It's the hip-hop show, but we just taking over.
Yeah. We're back on live with the hip-hop show. I am your host, Laron Pierce, and we have the guest here in the Prince of LA show because the topic is the Prince of LA Part 2.
The Prince of LA show with the guest, the hip-hop show.
The hip-hop show is the guest.
Did you just say the guest, the hip-hop show?
It's reverse. We came in, took over, and now he's on our show.
Boop, boop, boop. Again, stop trying to steal the spotlight. Gosh, give it to LP.
Hold up. Still, I
go
do
LP,
what I want.
Take the spotlight.
I'm sorry. It's just natural.
Nobody's stealing my spotlight. I'm just
it's
in
natural.
It.
It's natural.
But, yeah, so let's just go into the interview. So, Jizzle, so what we, so like, I heard you bringing a couple celebrities next year.
Well, you know, we're trying to. We've contacted a few so far. You know, we've been getting some responses, so I don't want to give away too many details, but you know, we've been contacting a lot, and we are still contacting a lot. So,
and if
just look forward
to
it,
you want
to
be out there, hit us up.
If you're an independent artist and you want to come on the show, just hit us up. Email us splatoutent.com. I mean, splatoutent@gmail.com.
splatoutent@gmail.com. You know, comedians, actors, actresses, anybody, singers, whatever you doing, if you out here really, really, really doing your
engineers.
Thing, you know what I'm saying? Engineers.
Exactly.
Anybody, you out there, you really trying to get out there, putting yourself, giving your all, hit us up, you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you on the show, put you out there.
Yeah.
Right? Because that's what we do. Boom! Blow ya! Boom! Boom! Like that, right?
Yep.
That's like that.
Like that. Goes down on the Prince of LA show. With me, A-Gang.
Yeah, so, yeah, I've been liking the show so far since I engineer the show all the time. So
right.
That's just me. But, yeah, so we've been having a little, like, have a good time, you know what I mean, on Friday.
Yeah.
Fridays, on Thursday nights, you know what I mean, 7 o'clock to 8, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so they'll be back on next week, so I'm looking forward to it, you know what I mean. But next week, we're going to have, I don't know if it's going to be confirmed, but it should be confirmed. We're going to have Vader V Lane in the mix next week.
He DJ?
So no, he's not a DJ. He's a rapper.
Oh, okay.
So he knows a lot of connections to, like, and I guess he knows one of my friend's cousins, but he's also my cousin, too. So, yeah, okay. We're going to talk about a lot of stuff. We're going to have a lot of topics about what is the state of hip-hop and... Mm-hmm. And we're going to promote his song, his favorite single. It's called "Hey, I'm Calling You Out." That's a great song. Like,
wait, the whole song
wait,
is "Hey,
I'm calling you out?
Well, the song is called "Hey," in parentheses is "Calling You Out."
Oh, okay. Okay, I thought you said "Hey, I'm calling you out," like talking to him.
Yeah.
No, that's actually what the song's about.
I mean,
you were talking to him saying you were calling him out.
No. That's the name of the song.
Okay, see.
But he's actually got a point. He's calling people out. Like, he's calling the music industry out. Like, so, yeah.
Okay, well, wow. You know, that can either make you or break you. It is. You know, you might just put your foot in your mouth, or you might take your foot through that other door.
He might be listening to the show right now, but Vader,
that's good. I mean, hey.
Tune in right now. Just call in 323-965-1600, man. Just call in to tell me what you think about the show and what and all that. So, you know what I mean? But back to the interview. So, Jizzle, what's going on with you this week?
Well, really nothing. I'm really on break right now, so I'm really not trying to.
Hey, I'm on break, but I'm working and doing all the other stuff, so yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm doing stuff as well, but this is time to rest. The industry is closed. The industry been closed. People are on vacation right now in the industry.
Front face.
That's why there are no vacation. I mean, there are no
really
auditions, anything. The industry is closed. So I'm just chilling, taking my vacation just like them. So once the year open up, then I'm going to come in with a bang. But I'm chilling for right now. This is my vacation. So I'm just...
Really?
Taking it slow.
I don't know what your excuse is, Jizzle, but I've been doing music and working 24/7 nonstop. I no, mean, let me take that back. 25-8.
Oh. But you know, sometimes because you love it, it's not considered work, so you're not going to sit and say work.
Laron Pierce.
You're right.
No, I'm just playing. But yeah, man, yes, we're all out here working, but right now, man, I'm just taking a vacation. Then once the new year comes...
He ain't
comes,
taking that much of a vacation. Don't let him fool y'all. He ain't sitting there acting like he really just...
Hey, I'm taking a school vacation because there's none of classes right now to next month, so
yeah,
I'm just
yeah.
chilling like a villain and starting the show, so yeah. That's what the show is all about. You know what I mean? I'm trying to get all the celebrities and engineers and all that stuff. So, yeah, everybody.
I want the tadpoles, the celebrities,
wow.
the middlemans.
Really?
Wow.
Yeah, it's a level to everything. I want to talk about. And
it's level to things. You
everybody.
Know what I'm saying?
And everything. Hey, we might mesh, we might not, but at least we try.
Oh, can we talk about something really quick? I think this.
What is about Jizzle?
I think this target the guys. Okay, so you know I have stopped playing video games.
Talk to the camera, man.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
If you
want
to talk to the guys? You want to talk to the camera?
I'm sorry. Okay. So man, so it's this new video game, right? Well, it's not new. I mean, it's called Grand Theft Auto. We all know. I'm pretty sure all the guys
really
like that game.
Sweet game.
I'm pretty sure all the guys like that game. Now, as you know, I think in 2013, they released Grand Theft Auto. Maybe before that, I don't know, but Grand Theft Auto 5 came out.
Yeah, it was released last year.
2013, I believe. But now they have dropped GTA 5 Next Gen on the PS4 and the Xbox One.
I don't think so, because this has been released already.
No, bro. That's what I'm saying. I said they released it. They released it.
Really? Are we really even talking about video games?
No, but what I'm saying,
for real?
But basically what I'm saying, they revamped
the video
the game
games
to
bring a hip hop culture, so there is a topic for hip hop. So yeah.
Oh,
they have big,
okay. Y'all want all right?
Maybe because she's a female, it doesn't really
ain't got
target
to do
her.
With it.
If
ain't
we
not,
were talking about
that ain't nothing to do with
Kim
so you
Chi
really,
at the nail shop,
stop
then
it.
She
so
might.
So you really finna try to sit here and separate like it's no females that play that?
I mean, it is female.
Okay, so why you wanna pick? Now you about to star some stuff. You can't be doing that.
LP,
acting
get
like,
my back, LP.
Acting
get
like
back.
Girls don't play that too. I ain't saying that I would.
But my point was the video game is revamped to target more like. More guys in a way, you know. Girls play the game too, but it's more entertaining to guys.
It ain't entertaining
you know
at all.
They dropped the PS4 and Xbox One Next Gen. Rockstar really developed that game, but what I disagree with is.
Well, I want to talk about.
Wow, I'm trying to get my point across, but I mean, LP, if you wanna take the light right now, you know,
because
A game is kind of.
I want to talk about Grand Theft Auto. Wow.
Hey,
I ain't gonna lie. Grand Theft Auto is the best game of all time.
Really? Put the camera on me. Watch this.
Oh, my God.
It's the best game. What? God. Drops headphones. I'm out of this piece.
Wow.
So, her game just left the building. Really?
No. Oh, is she serious?
She really left the building, really?
Come on, LP. Say what you had to say about the game. We'll get her back in studio on the break.
Yeah. I don't know. I never seen any news. I thought it was released a couple months ago.
No, it is released.
But
No, it did get released already.
Uh-huh.
Like you know, because, of course, since it's PS4 and Xbox One just came out, they had to make it for those systems. So they revamped it by adding new weapons, new cars, new missions.
Oh, they, of course.
Revamped it.
This is the next gen.
Every type of way. So the game, it's an excellent game, man.
Yeah.
And online, the story is a good storyline, but when you play online, it gives you a good experience, like experience like no other. It's like cool. So,
yeah.
A game kind of stormed out the studio, so I mean, we'll get her
back. She'll
be back. Over the break, we'll get her back.
She'll be back.
Can I get the time, LP?
We might go longer, so I'm not sure. So it's 10:15, but
okay.
I still got to do the Einstein songs of the day. So
okay, so
we can still talk about it.
Yeah, I mean, we got about 15-20 left, so I guess, you know, we'll get A-Game in the studio, we'll play all the unsigned artists, we'll talk about all that, you know, take over LP.
Yeah, we'll keep talking about it all. She's back in the building. speaking of hip-hop, you know what I mean?
I come back now. Are we still talking about video games?
No, we're not.
All right. I'm going to adjust myself right now, then. And I'm back. Hey, y'all. Hey, girl. I'm back. What's up?
Wow. So, yeah, let's go into more interview real quick. So, now I'm just kind of like thinking of what kind of like what I'm hoping or expecting for the Prince of LA show. So, I heard that you guys are like revamping like the show, like a lot of features and a lot of stuff that's.
We got some funny stuff. We got some little different things to see behind us in the background and stuff, you know what I'm saying? And yeah, we got some funny stuff coming. I hope you ready. He don't even know some of the stuff yet.
Well, dang.
That's just how fresh. You're going to like it, though.
I mean.
High five, we're going to have fun. Whoop. Oh.
Nice.
And there might be some more of that stuff coming, too.
Yeah. Yeah, it's guys.
All right, actually, I'm already part of the team, and I'm already the engineer, so I'm probably going to see a lot of stuff for it.
Yeah.
But,
yeah, you gonna know. Some
I hope
stuff
I see
might
a lot
a
of
surprise.
Females in this shit last year. I mean, next year. I see a lot of female rappers, producers, DJs next year.
I would like to see some more female MCs come on through. I'm doing my own little searching and stuff. And so if you get something from us, and you know what I'm saying, you might want to hit us back. Because I'm looking for some more female MCs, though, for real, to be on the show.
Yeah. Especially female singers. I'm looking for female singers right now for my debut album, Judge, Jury, Executioner.
He dropped it.
So, yeah.
So basically, everybody, what AM and LP is trying to say here, we're looking for female artists to collaborate with LP, female artists to come on our show.
Right.
And more female artists.
More MCs on my end. I mean, I'm with the R&B, I'm with the singers. That's, you know, that's a given. Especially ones that's not using auto-tunes and it's coming from the gut and all that good stuff. But, I'm looking for more MCs.
So,
though.
MCs
come
for her.
Come on, Wilty.
Okay, see.
Nah, but for real.
LP needs them for two reasons. And
hey,
you
it's
need
this
them.
Chick, though.
Two reasons? Wait a
I'm
minute.
I'm going to reach out to this
chick. Where did the second reason come from?
AM needs them for the show for MCs. You need them to collaborate. And, you know, LP might want a little girlfriend, so
here
look
he
out
goes.
For that. Look out for that, you know. I
maybe
mean.
We need to have a segment of the show with you doing some matchmaker.
LP on the spot.
You guys
are hearing this, right?
In the show, because, you know, might have a love segment.
The love segment.
Speaking of love, dating, sex type relationships and all that,
LP,
he say, she say, was just on 2 hours ago. So, okay. Yeah, they was a little crazy when I was engineering that show.
You know,
especially King Gerald, he can go all the way, like.
You say King who?
Dirty. King Gerald Jones. He was on my show last week.
Yeah, I know.
But yeah, he'll take stuff off the wall, like, sometimes.
Well, we got some stuff coming. I mean, it is going to be appropriate. I mean, it's going to be a little crazy, but it ain't going to be, you know, we don't, y'all know we keep clean.
We're not going to blurt out
the Prince of LA show, so yeah.
LP.
So, but we're going to have some stuff. Trust me, it's going to be funny. Guys. Maybe there's some skits coming, you know what I'm saying? Maybe some people.
To be honest with y'all?
Yes.
You guys will be laughing, you know what?
It's going to be so great. Oh, my gosh. Like, oh, my goodness. 2015 is going to be so dope. We're going to have all these people coming in.
Now, we're going to have
and stuff. It's going to be so dope, right, Jizzle?
4 Thursdays every month. Tune in.
Thursday, 7 p.m.
I didn't get to finish. Y'all just went over something.
We took off. That's what we do.
Introduce the unsigned artist. Take this off our hands, LP.
No. I'm going to do that a little later in a couple minutes. But I was just saying, I'm not going to lie. I'm still digging. You guys will be laughing.
Why? I'm probably not going to be surprised. What?
Yeah, we have 10, LP. Take it over.
What
you guys do? Already know already, so.
We know.
Yeah. If you guys want to say it, go ahead.
What? I don't know.
Okay, I maybe.
What? What do you think it is?
Our last guest on the show. She took our show out.
Who, Ella
for
Rowe?
The year. Ella.
You got it.
Miss Rogue.
What? Oh, you dating her, Laron?
No, you didn't date her. He didn't date her.
Oh, you bring her on the show?
It's one of them. I see
you. That's one of the moments, you know.
It's one of them. I see you. Nah, she was cool, though. I like Ella. Ella was cool. Shout out to Ella Rogue. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, Laron.
We're going to keep her in our mix. That's for sure.
She said that her age on the show. Hey. I wish I could see his face, though, because you can't see his face on our show. Because, like, he's engineering.
He don't have a camera. Yeah,
he's
engineering, he don't have a camera on our show. But
when she said her age, she said, that's my age.
I didn't say it like that, so I don't know what y'all talking about.
He said, that's my age.
He was highly intrigued. There's nothing wrong with it, Miss Ella. See you, girl.
I mean, you're a singer.
We're going to run her back. I mean, you know she's going to be back in the show. You know,
of course.
You can,
I'm going to be here to see it.
Didn't I leave the show once already?
He said, I'm going to be here to see it.
I might have to exit the building early again. One more again.
Well, you ain't going anywhere.
We have 9 left, guys. So we're going to try to fit everything in this 9. Take it over, LP.
Oh, I thought you was going to say A-game.
Yeah.
He said,
Enough with the love struggle by Ella Rose.
He said, I'll be here to see
Ella
it.
Shout out to Ella Rose. She's doing her thing and all that. And I just like her style and the music
Hit
and everything.
Hit me up, girl. Be all in the video. What? Oh, Ella Rose.
Ella Rose, if you're tuning in, just hit us up on 323-965-1600.
Riz.
If you're watching this.
Riz.
Anyway, so let's go into the unsigned rappers.
Scooby-Doo.
I already played one of the artists already.
Who
Maybe
was
the
that?
Same song, but I'm going to play.
Who
but before I play that song, Perceptions by Samuel Benta, a.k.a. Mysterious. He's a British actor, rapper, you know.
Okay.
But I'm going to play my boy Illa R, the Sandman. That's like a Mark Henry's theme song.
Mr.
The WWE.
Sandman.
Yeah, the WWE's Mark Henry theme song is called That's What I Do. But even though that's not really an official theme song, but that should be Mark Henry's theme song. But LR the Sandman, that's what I do.
In the past weeks, I've made my presence felt in destroying all who oppose me.
The next phase of the music, you love it while I produce it.
Yeah, Jaggy D in the place to be and all that shit.
Murder of my censure, don't even ask questions. Lyrically benefited, that's what I do. I ain't gonna lie, I never really tried. Till the day I die, that's what I do. Murder of my censure, don't even ask questions. Lyrically benefited, that's what I do. I ain't gonna lie, I never really tried. Till the day I die, that's what I do. Wake up, brush teeth, make daily rounds. Say what's goody to my people, chillin' in my town. They will tell me, nigga, you should've been around. Tell me what went down, I laughed and I'm out. Go to the barbershop, see my dude Randy. Neighborhood barber, shape ups come in handy. Jump in the cab, cooking it fast, go to Crown Diner. Cheese omelet with beef bacon, fire. Leave a nice sip, after that got a dip. To the strip, see what's going on with my chips. But all that is confidential, venom on the instruments. So a lot of bullshit I've been through, but I still stay official. Let's get back to how the day went. Went to the basement, put stacks in the bins. Get dressed for the club, got Henny in the mug. Wanna leave the spot, the night is a dog.
And it's just a matter of time before one of those faces come eye to eye with the silverback.
Murder of Mike says shit, don't even ask questions. Lyrically benefited, that's...
Okay, I don't know what happened to the music, so I guess we're not going to play anything, so... yeah. I guess people are saying that the music
anyway.
Is the same, so yeah, I don't know what's going on. But.
Well, you know, I got some music. Y'all want to hear my music?
What? Take it.
Oh, yeah, wait. No.
I couldn't do the scratch.
I apologize that you couldn't hear the whole song, but we're probably going to go to like 2 more songs before we end up. So we're going to go to my boy T Cash.
Studio.
Tyler Hacker, a.k.a. T Cash. You know what I mean? He's he goes to my school, Los Angeles Recording School. You know what I mean? He just started now. 5 months ago, you know.
Okay.
But yeah, it's called, this is an old song, by the way. It's called Never Take Me Alive, so let's go ahead and check it out.
You never take me alive, take me alive. Boy, smooth, check it out. Okay, look. Hard enough to open my eyes. Streets make it hard to keep them wide. Don't ask why. Decide what's real and what's a lie. High speed, fast life, the code that we was got by. West to 100%, back no point. Why? Tealy to the top. I'm a hustler to fly like a grizzly in a pot. Y'all fronting, we asking why. I aiming for the prize. Money, hunting, truth, no lies. Hoping season and my beam is stuck up on a money sign. Hoping season, y'all hopers. Flip the white Obama promoter. Stay focused. Louis bag, young loaster. Get your girl juvenile dick, that slow motion. Never take me alive. I'm deeper than the insides. No shirt, no shoes. Slip and slide. I'm a ride. Hear it, now it go like a casino with a dough. White bitch flipping De Niro. Check out my zeros. Rangatang, chain swing. There me and money go. Fresher than a sir. Better address me as sir. Press you like a shirt. Sick words. We flip the herb. Money on your head and I'll show you what's your worth. Be it like a curse, cause they hate it, they at first. And I ask first, understand that like some standards.
And they be like, damn, Shake, why you go so hard?
Shit is gutter in the hood, niggas gotta keep it real.
And niggas wonder why I walk around the hood with my shirt off.
Shit is gutter in the hood, niggas gotta keep it real.
Niggas always wonder why I'm turned up in the hood.
Shit is gutter in the hood, niggas gotta keep it real.
Niggas wonder why I got that fat ass rollie on my neck.
Shit is gutter in the hood, niggas gotta keep it real. Shit is gutter in the hood, niggas gotta keep it real.
Popping pistols every day, so you gotta keep that steel. Niggas eat you like a meal, I pop you like a pill. I keep it rolling like a whip, niggas know what it is. Up with the beers, hoodie chucks, pistol grip. Give a fuck who you with, smooth stuff a nigga quick. I told you we the shit, I get it hopping in this bitch. I keep it popping like a switch, weed, sticky potted grip. Young trick, not no bitch, big worm, not no snitch. Niggas hook you like a fence, 50 shots up in this bitch.
Shit was gutty in the hood, niggas.
Man,
hey,
I just realized there's a lot of nonsense at the end of the song, but Yeah. It's cool. I mean, it's still a great song.
It's raw hip hop, you know?
I don't want to play the whole thing with that song, you know what I mean? But I'm going to take it away with this last song we're going to play by Perceptions by Mysterious, a.k.a. Samuel Benson. Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, did you ever think to liberate? Should have been your cause. I'm tired of the frustration, tired of segregation. Nothing pisses me off more than the misinformation that they teach to the youth. Them poisoning minds and teaching them to shoot them. I'm done with this. Generations after generations running the same program, manipulating biological genes of man. I know it's complicated. We've been oppressed for years and white dominated. I'm done with this shit. I'm running this shit. And I will study this shit. Use the power of the Neo. I'm in front of this shit. So take that. Reverse back your Willy Lynch syndrome. You're messing with perceptions at the frequency system. I see ya, I see ya. Wouldn't wanna be ya. Cause and effect, swing right to the left.
What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be. What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be.
Is it a bird or a plane? Spoken word, I get the word out again. Me one, you already get the word out the telly. Data waves on your celly, they got ya. Ooh, they got ya. No vision, you perish. That's the bottom line, not said. Brain dominates, head, shoulders, knees, toes, legs. So get to know how you think, how you're hardwired. Reprogram your neural pathways and firewire. I drop the knowledge, I can smack you around your left ear. Leave you with a new ringtone. Clear, backtrack is admitted in my no-fear realm. Speak your word and smile in my no-tear realm. Extra, extra, read all about it. Proof, I got proof, truth, read all about it. So don't be coming with your earth-flat nonsense. It's all about what I see in my conscience.
What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be. What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be.
Wake up and smell the coffee, your brain dead. Positive and negative, recharge your brain stem. Face them in order to erase them. This ain't no joking, they're constantly provoking and they pimping your legacy. Sucking all your energy, telling you you'll never beat me. While you are ready, evacuate the paradigm. Reboot and light speed, leave your things behind. Focus on the high energy. To boldly go where no man has gone before. Hit you in the kundalini, twitching all on the floor. Mister, mister, your first eye is blind. This ain't no Specsavers, if you seek you'll find. With a mind, the process of manifestation.
vision and soul elevation, the mind penetration. Sages done told you this. Frontal lobe observer, get a hold of this. You in the driver's
what
seat.
What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be. What is this thing that's called my perception? What I see is who I be, my perception. Who I be is what I see, my perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be. My perception. My perception. My perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be. My perception. My perception. My perception. It all comes down to what I see and who I be.
Hey, hey, B.
Yeah, boy.
That's how we do it.
In the building, about to exit the building again.
That's how we do it on the hip hop show / the Prince of LA show. We're guests on the hip hop show. It's such an honor for you bringing us on, LP.
Again.
Man, that's an honor and a pleasure.
Yeah, boy, no problem. Anytime. Next time, just bring me.
Wow, did she just sneak this like that? Wow, it's all right.
Slide.
It's all right. She can always diss me anyway.
I don't know what I can say to that, but...
yeah.
No, maybe if I, teamwork. Teamwork, A-game. Prince of LA.
But if I do bring you A-game, I'll probably just bring, like, maybe for adults, maybe. I'm not sure.
Get that 21 and over.
Yeah.
Sorry,
sorry, Jizzle.
I'm 22, so.
Sorry, son.
Nah.
I have to leave you at home.
Sorry, Jizzle.
LP, you barely make the deadline, LP. You barely make the deadline.
It don't matter. Barely is, it is what it is.
Barely made the deadline.
He talking
about 2 years ago.
I know, that's 2 years ain't a long time. Trust me.
Well, 21, boom. And then now 22, that's a year over the, yeah, boom.
Next year I'll be 23. Well, I mean. Aww.
Look out for him, Ella.
You really got to say that, bro? Wait, say that again.
Look at him.
Wait, wait, wait. Say that again.
Look at him.
Wait, say that again.
Look out for him, Ella.
Really?
Look at look at
him. Don't be acting like you don't.
Laron blushing. Hey, when we leave, he's going to be talking about it. It's all good. It's all good. You supposed to like the ladies. You
all we're going to do is sitting at the mic, going to talk about Ella Rogue. Sitting on the hip-hop show with Laron.
Come on, why you putting him on the spot?
Laron.
Oh, come on.
I'm actually sampling this after we get this show. After I end this show.
Hey, if she sees this, oh, my God. She's going to be like, wow, it's a topic.
Yeah, girl. Yes, girl.
If this is going to be a part three, then it's probably going to be talking about Laron.
Yeah, look.
Oh, my.
We need to play. We're going to have to let Laron. She don't even know she's about to be on the hip-hop show.
Oh, my God.
Well, I don't know. I'm just saying.
No, she's dope though. We like
yeah.
her. We wouldn't be doing all this if we didn't like it, girl. Nah, she's cool though. Good.
So I guess next time for the Prince of LA show, probably gonna be the Prince of LA Part 3.
Ooh.
Featuring Ella Rose.
No.
Who knows?
Have my people call your people call my people or her people. No, I'm just playing.
Man.
Nah, but for real. Nah, you never know. All type of stuff.
Yeah, anything happens, but...
Mixing shows, visiting, you know what I'm saying? We're going to do... Oh, no, shit. We're going to do all that stuff.
Well, take it over, LP. It was a pleasure having me and A-Game on the show.
Yeah, thanks.
Selfie cam.
We're family.
Selfie cam.
Selfie
that's tight, huh? How it's moving. We're going to
do a selfie cam. Come on, look. It's moving. Do it again. I like that. Come on, look. See, that's what they see.
Selfie cam.
Ooh. No.
Thanks, everybody, for tuning in to the hip-hop show / the guest Prince of LA show. It's an honor for you bringing the song.
Again.
Take over the light, LP.
Man, it was an honor. I mean, thank you for having me as your engineer for your show. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah, you're in business. Yeah. All right, we won't want nobody else but you, LP. I like how I did that, huh?
Thank you.
I appreciate you guys. I appreciate all you guys tuning into the show, especially for Prince of LA. You know what I mean? But, yeah, so before we end the show, just give out your Twitter, Facebook, social media, this and that.
Before we end the show. Well, you already know, A-Game on Instagram, AY_GAME, where you find your girl. And what else? Prince of LA Show, at the Prince of LA Show, at RJizzle Westbred. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Follow us up. Hit us up, splatoutent@gmail.com. Want to be on the show? Go on, check out some of our previous shows on rmconair.com. Check us out. Trust me, you want to be on the show. We get it in.
Yep.
Right? That was my spiel. I'm done. Mic's dead. No, I don't have a mic. Headphones down.
Wow. Okay, well, everybody, this is right here, our Jizzle with the selfie cam. As you can see, it's not stationary. Hey, that's what you like, that the selfie cam, as you can see. Follow me at RJizzleWestbred_ on Instagram. Follow me on Twitter. You can add the Facebook, but I don't really be on it unless I'm promoting. But you can add... Wow, are you still in my selfie cam spotlight? She mad because I came up with the selfie cam. But,
I like it, though. I do like it. I like it.
Yeah,
I
but like but it. Anyway, you can follow me, The Prince of LA Show. Follow LP. It was a pleasure, everybody. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you. I just want to thank everybody.
Are you kissing?
No, I'm just...
Well, I'm just a little upset that we ain't got no calls, but it's cool. I got Prince of LA once again, part two, you know what I'm saying? Part three is coming soon. Maybe not next week. Maybe the following week, I don't know. You know, it could be A-Game in the background dancing and stuff.
A-Game in everybody camera, yeah. Now.
I appreciate all you guys listening to the show. You know, shout out to my family, my dad, my uncle, owner Roscoe's, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Scott Taylor, a.k.a. Scotty Trippin. It was some sort of beef that was going on because I was, wasn't a beef, but it was kind of like taken out of context what I said about make an example for like YG and DJ Mustard beef. It was weak and all that, and I put him and myself on it, and it was kind of like not cool for Scott to say that, but it didn't make sense, so I deleted it and made my own part just to talk about the beef. It was just kind of horrible, but yeah, so Scott, I really apologize, man. You know what I mean? You my homie, you my brother, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit would never happen to me, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, but on that note, man, I appreciate you guys. What is going on? Again, I appreciate you guys tuning in to the show. It'll be part four, and I'm bringing in Vader, a.k.a. V-Lane, in the building. We're going to be singing, hey, 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 I'm calling you out. You know what I'm saying? We're actually going to promote that single, you know what I mean? But he was previously on Generation U Radio Show, and I'm happy to have him on as my show next week. So yeah, so stay tuned, everybody. I am your host, Laron Pierce. You can find me on Instagram, Twitter, all the same name, no spaces or no nothing. LaronPierce. And you can Google me. You can find all my old mixtapes and all that, you know what I mean? Let's go into another song. Well, not another song, but we ended it with another song. So I hope you guys tune in next week.
And better back this by is the camera, last... Ella Rowe gonna come for you.
Oh, in the background, really? You gonna say it by Ella Rowe?
Yeah.
Okay, no, all right. I think the Prince of LA coming through to my show, even though they're not gonna be on the air this week again, but they're gonna be back next week, and I'll be there to see it. Yeah. I hope Ella Rowe's there. I'm just kidding.
Hey, he was serious.
No, he wasn't.
I'm just kidding.
Wasn't.
He said, "I'm just kidding."
Switch the camera on, man.
But yeah, so I hope you guys tune in next week with Vader, a.k.a. V-Lane, Mr. A, I'm calling you out. Stay tuned. Same time, same everything. Just tune in and please call in. I don't care if you're a family member. I don't care if you're family or friends. None of that. Just call in. All right, I'm out. This is your host, Laron Pierce, signing out to the Hip Hop Show. Peace.
I will.
Yo, who with it? Gonna make it move with it. Mind, body, spirit, beats in the lyrics. Never heard nothing like this before, you hear me? We smooth with it, got the groove with it. Yo, who with it? Gonna make it move with it. Mind, body, spirit, beats in the lyrics. Never heard nothing like this before, you hear me? Coming with production that will take over corruption. Lyrics that will preserve rather than go with destruction. Smooth like silk and glass, so step aside as we show you how it's done. Our music can never divide. All together now, cause we're here for the better now. Making the cheddar now, no matter the weather, pal. Getting ahead of foul, mentalities that allow all the foolishness to go on, playing them out aloud. Wearing the ears out, painting is effective. That's where we're coming with a new group of collective. Sounds that will suit the mind state to improve the shine. Wait, we're standing right behind. Great, don't mean the most refined. Take it to utilize, wait, use it as our own escape from common world outside the gate. We make it true to us, never left them in the dust. Turn it on from the rust, rising from the earth's crust. Who you really wanna trust? Smooth with it, got the groove with it. Yo, who with it? Gonna make you move with it. Mind, body, spirit.